subscribe and hit the bell icon for more notifications.
Hi friends, welcome back to Best Way to Study. In this video, we are going to see what are the most important topics coming to TCS NQT and what topics you need to concentrate in order to crack TCS NQT, okay? First, let's see what are the different sections of the exam. Questions for TCS NQT will be asked from verbal ability is very, very important. Reasoning ability, aptitude, okay? So, okay, see, coming to NQT paper, let's divide NQT paper into two parts. Both the parts are very important. First part will contain verbal ability, reasoning and aptitude questions. And in the second section, questions will be asked from programming and coding. Okay. Now let's see what are the important topics under each of this section. Okay. So 24 questions will be asked. Okay. So generally, coming to verbal ability, 24 questions will be asked and there is no negative marking. Okay. So there is no negative marking coming to verbal ability. But the thing is, out of 24 questions, cutoff is going to be at least 20 plus. Okay. So you need to at least answer 20 plus questions correctly in order to cross the cutoff for verbal ability. Okay. The duration of this particular exam is 30 minutes. Okay. 30 minutes. So you have 24 questions and 30 minutes. So you should not give more than 1 minute per question. Okay. In 1 minute, you must solve a question. Okay. What are the most important topics coming to verbal ability? Okay. So first most important topic is reading comprehension. Okay. First most important topic is reading comprehension. And coming to this, every year at least 5 to 6 questions will be asked from reading comprehension, which is very, very important. And after reading comprehension, you need to concentrate on grammar. Okay. So most of the questions will be based on grammar, such as sentence correction, statement improvement and all. So you need to be very good with grammar. Okay. And next, you need to concentrate on synonyms and antonyms. Okay. Synonyms and antonyms. Very, very important. At least 2 to 4 questions will be asked every year, which is very, very important. Synonyms means meanings. You should find the meaning of the word. Antonyms means you must find the opposites of the word. Okay. So, coming to the reading comprehension, read question first, okay? So, instead of reading the entire passage, read the questions first and then start searching the answers for those questions, okay? It will really save a lot of time, okay? Next, you need to concentrate on close test. Close test is also very, very important. At least 5 to 7 questions will be asked from close test every year. Okay, so these 4 are very, very important topics and you need to cover each of them under verbal ability. Okay, so 5 to 6 questions will be asked from reading comprehension. Questions related to grammar will be asked, which is very important. And synonyms and antonyms are very, very important. Most of the students will be losing marks in synonyms and antonyms. Okay. Apart from this, also you need to concentrate on error identification or sentence improvement or error correction. This is also very, very important. First one is error identification. Means they'll give you a sentence and you need to identify the error. Sentence improvement. They'll give you a sentence and you need to improve the grammar of those of that sentence. Okay. And error correction means they'll give you an error. You need to correct that error. Okay. And next is sentence completion. Very, very important. And last but not least, passage ordering. They'll give zigzag format of the passages and you need to put those passages in a specific order which gives the passage a correct meaning. Okay, so these are very much important coming to verbal ability. Now let's see what are the most important topics coming to logical ability. Okay, so the logical ability, 30 questions will be asked. 30 questions will be asked and you need to at least answer 23 plus questions correctly in order to crack the cutoff, in order to cross the cutoff. Okay, the duration of this particular logical ability is 50 minutes. Okay, so in 50 minutes you need to answer 30 questions correctly. Okay, for one question you can averagely give 1 minute, and for few questions, see I'm repeating, only for few questions you can give 1.5 to 2 minutes. Okay, so like this you need to divide the time allocation and you need to decide how much time you're going to allocate for each and every question in that particular section. Okay, the difficulty level of this particular section will be high. It will be difficult compared to other sections. Now let's see what are the important topics coming to logical ability. Okay, so first you need to concentrate on number series. Very, very important. Number series. Okay, every year coming to number series, 5 to 7 questions will be asked. So now you might have understood the importance of number series. And after this, you need to concentrate on odd man out. Odd man out. Very important. Odd man out. Okay. So coming to odd man out also, 4 to 5 questions will be asked every single year. Okay. So next important is distance and directions. The questions will be based on the distance and direction. Okay, also questions will be asked on data sufficiency. Very, very important. And also age-based problems will be asked. Son's age is so and so, son's age is X, father's age is Y. What is the difference between their age? So these sort of age-based problems also will be asked. So all these together, 4 to 6 questions will be asked every year. Okay. Formula-based problems. Okay. So few questions will be completely based on formula. So questions will also be asked from coding, decoding. Very, very important. And easy also. Okay, it will be at the level of medium or easy. It's very, very easy. And next is blood relation problem. Coming to the blood relation, start reading question from last to first. Okay, you can solve the blood relation questions very easily if you start reading the question from last to first. Concentrate on seating arrangement problems. Okay, so they may ask any kind of seating arrangement problems. It may be linear seating arrangement, or it may be linear seating arrangement or circular linear arrangement. Let's see what are the most important topics coming to numerical ability. called aptitude. Okay, so coming to the numerical ability, 26 questions will be asked. 26 questions will be asked from numerical ability. At least make sure 20 plus questions will be correctly answered. Okay, and the duration is 40 minutes. In 40 minutes, you need to solve 26 questions. Let's see what are the important topics coming to numerical ability or quantitative aptitude. You need to concentrate on LCM and HCF problems. Very, very important. At least 4 to 5 questions will be asked every year from LCM and HCF. Time, speed and distance is also very, very important. And you should also concentrate on probability, permutations and combinations, and also geometry and clocks and calendars. These are very, very important topics coming to numerical ability. Okay, but from this, also concentrate on work and time, work and time, which is also very important, profit and loss. Okay, so these are the most important topics coming to numerical ability. Next is, you need to concentrate on programming MCQs. Okay, on programming languages, MCQs will be asked. Okay, 10 questions will be asked from these programming MCQs. Make sure you answer at least 6 plus questions correctly in order to cross the cutoff. Okay, and coming to the time limit, you will have 15 minutes time limit. Okay, so in 15 minutes, you should answer 10 questions. Okay, now let's see what are the most common questions asked from these programming MCQs. First, you need to concentrate on data types. Okay, mostly from data types, MCQs will be asked. Data types, functions, recursion, iteration. You need to concentrate on these topics. File handling, loops, stacks and queues, OOPs concept, caching and sorting, very important, searching and sorting. Time complexity. Okay, so these are very, very important topics coming to programming MCQs. So you need to concentrate on mostly these topics. After this, there will be a coding test. Coming to the coding question, for one question, there will be 15 minutes of duration. If they give two questions, there will be 30 minutes of duration. Okay, so this is the pattern. These are most important topics which I told you. And coming to the coding, you can write a program in C, C++ or any language. You can write in Java or Python. It's up to you. Whatever language you're comfortable with that particular language, you can write your code, but within the given time limit. In next video, I'm going to tell what are the most frequently repeated questions in TCS NQT exam. So if you want that video and if you want to get the video notification, make sure you subscribe to my channel and hit the bell icon. And also don't forget to like and share this video with all your friends. Thanks for watching.